JJ?
Yep.
Right, he's going live now, so just watch, you know.
Hot mic, yeah, I got you.
You don't have to talk yet, but you don't know when this is going to start over there, so.
All right.
I should tell you. You were begging for me.
No.
Thank you. I'm happy with this. Thank you.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12.
So he was just, he couldn't
beat
the game, so he was trying to watch it, so.
Who are you the family of?
Oh,
alright.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, alright. Awesome. I'd like to see the away parents getting involved and all that, too.
Yeah. Well,
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we would like to have our senior presentation.
Thank you.
For our senior players, I'd like to thank their family members for their longtime support in all their academic and athletic endeavors. Our first senior, number 15, Dylan Pals, presenting to Mom Lisa, Dad Brandon, and Sister Jillian. Senior, Captain Number 8, DJ Bikini, presenting to his dad, Bill, Mom Shirley, who's not with us this evening at work, and brother DJ, and sisters Catherine. Assistant Captain Number 11, Austin Bernard, presenting to Mom Amy, Dad Rich, and Sister Tia. Number 26, Jack Cameron, presenting to Mom Ann and Dad David and Sister Lily. Number 4, Matthew Cappuccetti, presenting to Dad Jason. Although Matt's mom Erin is no longer with us, we know she is beaming down tonight with great pride. Captain number 22, Cam. Sister Lily, brother Tyler, on the JV Beverly High School team. Everside. Senior number 12, Jeff Halloran, presenting to Dad Chris, Mom Sue, and Brother Steve. Captain number 17, Matthew Meza, presenting to Dad Tim, Mom Christine, brothers Andrew, alumni, Beverly High School player, and Jonathan, a JV Beverly High School team member. Number 20, Rocco Orlandella, presenting to Mom Erin, Sister Tyler. Senior, number 6, Will Ten Hope. Presenting to Dad Paul, Mom Leslie, Brother Jack, an alumni Beverly High School player. Assistant Captain number 5, Jackson Thomas. Presenting to Mom Amanda, Dad Dickie, Sister Olivia, and Brother Emmett. put your hands together for the class of 2022 seniors for Beverly High School, and wish them all the best in all their athletic and academic endeavors.
Welcome in, everyone, to the Raymond Shape Bork Arena here in Beverly, Mass. I'm J.J. Sylvia, welcoming you into another installment of Beverly High School Boys Ice Hockey here on BevCam Sportsnet. And tonight, folks, it's senior night, and we're honoring 13 individual seniors for the Beverly program. And I'm going to list all of them off in just a moment before we get set for this matchup, as the Panthers are set to welcome in Swamp Scott to the Bork. And this matchup is going to be crucial as the season dwindles down toward the state tournament. Both these squads have potential to see their season prolonged past the regular season into the state tournament. So a victory tonight for either side would be crucial as they look ahead towards the MIAA state tournament. And before we get started, let's talk about all those seniors. So there's 13 of them total graduating, and you can see over behind Beverly's net, there's banners up for each of the 13 seniors in honor of their dedication to the program over the past ever so many seasons that they've been a part of it. Dylan Alves, DJ Bikini, Austin Bernard, Jack Cameron, Matthew Cappuccetti, Cam Cook, Max Edelstein, Jeff Hallinan, Chase O'Brien, Matthew Meza, Rocco Orlandella, Will Tenhope, and Jackson Thomas, all honored as future graduating seniors during the pregame ceremonies for the Panthers. And it'll be a senior-packed starting lineup tonight for Beverly, as all five skaters, other than the goaltender, are seniors to start out for the Panthers. They'll send out Austin Bernard, Matthew Meza, and Cam Cook as the forwards, with Matthew Cappuccetti and Jackson Thomas as the D-pairing. And then James O'Connell will be in between the pipes tonight for the Panthers. The junior getting a chance to show off his skills against a Swamp Scott squad that is quite formidable, and we'll talk a little bit about them later on. But let's look at the Swamp Scott's starting lineup as well. They'll send Zach Pierce, Aiden Sprague, and Max Gordon out there to counter Beverly's full senior unit as the forwards. And then the D pairing for Swamp Scott's Big Blue will be Quinn Hitchcock and TJ McCarthy, with Jason Buffard in between the pipes tonight for Big Blue. Both these squads getting ready here during warm-ups. We're about 3 minutes shy of puck drop here at the Bork, and a full fan section out in support of the Panthers tonight. You can see it on the far side, just to the left of the home bench. A huge student section coming out in full force tonight here at the Bork. We are going to take a very short break as we look towards the opening faceoff. I'm JJ Sylvia, and we will see you on the other side here on BevCam Sportsnet.
Now, for our starting lineup, beginning with visiting
Big Blue from Swampscott. At left wing, senior number 11, Zach Pierce. At center, junior number 20, Aiden Sprague. At right wing, senior number 7, Max Gaden. On defense, junior number 17, TJ McCarthy. On defense, sophomore number 2, Quinn Hitchcock. And in goal, sophomore number 1, Jason Bufford. Big Blue is led by head coach Gino Fea and is assisted by coach Mike Delisio. Now for you, Beverly Cutler! At left wing, senior number 11, Austin Bergon! At center, senior number 17, Matt Mezza! At right wing, senior number 22, Cam Crow! On defense, senior number 5, Jackson Thomas. Also on defense, senior number 4, Matt Cappuccetti. And in goal, number 30, junior Jim O'Connell. The Old Panthers are led by head coach Jim Sasso and is assisted by coach Andrew Scott. At this time, we ask that you please rise for the playing of our national anthem.
Here in the Raymond J. Bork Arena, J.J. Sylvia along with you here on BevCam Sportsnet as we're just about set to get underway here on Senior Night. Let's meet the starting lineups once more for the Panthers. Austin Bernard at the left wing, Matthew Mezza at center, and Cam Cook at the right wing with Matthew Cappuccetti and Jackson Thomas as the deep pairing, and James O'Connell, the junior goaltender, in between the pipes. And then for the Swampscott Big Blue, Zach Pierce at the left wing, Aiden Sprague at center, and Max Gaudon at right wing, with Quinn Hitchcock and TJ McCarthy as the D pairing, and Jason Buford in between the pipes, the sophomore, getting the nod tonight for Big Blue and head coach Gino Fea. Face off about to come at center ice. Sprague, and we're underway with Beverly winning the opening faceoff. Jackson Thomas up there. I mentioned the opportunity for both these squads to potentially make a run in the upcoming tournament. Both these squads have a lot of work to do to get there. They're below 500, both of them, but obviously with the way the Massachusetts State Tournament is set up, a sub-500 record with enough good competition in your schedule could set you up for a bid in the tournament, whether it's a low or a high seed. That's a whole nother debate to have as it's worked down into the Beverly end. Jackson Thomas to grab it there. Thomas going high off glass to find DJ Bikini. Bikini, one of those seniors, and he's been around a while. Last time I called the game here a few years ago, he notched a goal for the Panthers. So DJ Bikini, no stranger to the big moments at the varsity level. As Swampscott once again, moving it down into the Beverly end. And the Panthers with Gavin Lawrence will start back up on the rush. Lawrence finding Aiden LeBlanc. Going around his goal, moving it up ahead, DJ Bikini. Bikini crossed the line into the offensive zone. Hesitates at the high slot and fires for a stop by Buford. Now giving chase for the Panthers is LeBlanc as it's pushed over to this near side. And Swampscott able to move it out. Pass across ice for Will Roddy. Unable to corral it completely to be gathered for the Panthers on the back end by Lawrence once again. And now a rush brewing here for Beverly. McAlpine puts it high over the goal and it trickles back out in front. Bit of a scare there for Buford, but it stays out, keeping it 0-0. About 2.5 minutes gone here in period one. Jackson Thomas going far side, shot from a bad angle that was taken for the Panthers by Rocco Orlandella. Never got all the way to the goal. Now in the far corner, Beverly looking to move it out into the slot. But Swampscott stacking that goal line, not allowing the passes to get in front near board. Kept in up top to the far side, Jackson Thomas. Thomas cycling it below the goal. Swampscott heavily clouding that slot area, especially the high slot, could be something to look for as this game progresses. As any good hockey team knows, the more you can cover the slot in the weak side, the better. Jackson Thomas from the point gets the scoring started on senior night. And it's 1-0 Beverly. Big goal there for Jackson Thomas. And to reference masshighschoolhockey.com, according to their statistics, that would be his third goal of the season. So the Panthers, only about 3 minutes into this game already, on top over Big Blue, 1-0. And a tough bounce for the sophomore goalie, Jason Buford, for Swampscott. Not the way he wanted this game to start out. Now feet up top, another shot from the point. Buford with the blocker save. Far side Meza going below the goal for Cook. Cook back into the slot. Meza a chance. And pinning it underneath his right pad is Jason Buford for the stoppage of play with 11:21 to go in this first. Beverly knocking on the door already for goal number two. And now DJ Bikini's unit heading out to the ice. Bikini centering Aiden LeBlanc as well as Jeffrey Hallinan at the right wing. And then Jackson Thomas on the D pairing with Gavin Lawrence. Now to the near side, Cody Langevin will push it down into Beverly's end. Panthers trying to clear, but Big Blue making that hard. Pushed down toward that far corner by Hitchcock before Beverly is able to work it out to center, and Hitchcock forcing it back into the Panther end. About 4.5 gone here at the Bork already. A 1-0 Panther lead here on BevCam Sportsnet. Goal coming from Jackson Thomas, and what a great way for the Panthers to start senior day with a goal to start from a senior. Now Hallinan, behind the goal, will give way for his teammate. And the Panthers cycle it before it's worked back out to center by Swampscott, as those wingers have done a good job so far for Big Blue of stepping up towards the point and making it harder for those Beverly defenders to work the offense through them. And a stoppage here looked like it was an icing, and it will bring it down into the Panther end to the right of James O'Connell. Face off won by the Panthers, pushed up this near board by Robert Massa. And Beverly able to work it out to center. Orlandella forcing up the near board, trying to gain the zone. Delayed off sides will give Swampscott a chance to move in the other direction. Nice hit there on that far board by Orlandella. Swampscott still on the move. Nice play on the defensive back end there for the Panthers as stepping up and sticking the puck away there was Robert Massa. So now Swampscott, after seeing Beverly take the early lead, trying to maintain some presence in their offensive zone, perhaps looking to notch an early tie and get this game back to squares. Beverly looking to turn D into O in rapid fashion. Jack Cameron gets pushed off the puck far board, and it looks like an offside was called, stopping the clock with 9:18 still to go in this first period here on senior night. Matthew Mezzo, one of the captains in there on the draw, and he will lose it this time around to Aiden Sprague. Mezzo, however, to take the loose puck in neutral ice and dump it down and in. Let's see how the Beverly forecheck fares so far. Bernard with a nice check below the goal. Might have caused a turnover, but a whistle. And it looks like Austin will be charged with a penalty here in the first power play of the game for either side. And Swampscott will draw first blood as Austin Bernard heads to the sin bin. And he will take a 2-minute seat. Swampscott to the power play here. So that first unit out there to start this power play for Big Blue, Pierce, Sprague, and Gadon. And then Quinn Hitchcock out there on D with Zach Ryan as well, serving as the second defenseman for this Swampscott power play. Mezzo winning the draw and sending it all the way down the ice is Cappuccetti. So the first power play of the evening, and Swampscott could not have hoped for better. Already down by one, a vital opportunity to tie this game up. Now down low, Hitchcock trying to find the lane toward the slot, had nowhere to go, retreating back up top for Gadon. Gadon near side, Zach Ryan trying to feed it down that near board, and it's nudged back all the way down onto Buford, who will cover it up. As quickly crashing in on him was Cam Cook. And another whistle to bring a faceoff in front of Buford. Still a minute 19 left on the Swampscott power play. JJ Sylvia here with you on BevCam Sportsnet. I'd like to extend a hearty welcome to all our viewers from both Beverly and Swampscott tonight. Glad you could join us here on this Saturday evening for this tilt between the Panthers and Big Blue. Hitchcock to pilot this drive forward here with a minute to go on the Big Blue power play. Far side, Hitchcock connecting with Sprague across the line. Looks to feed it middle. He connects with Roddy. Roddy below the goal, knocked off the puck by Jackson Thomas. And the puck beach balled below the goal and now worked back up top. Hitchcock will give and go with his left winger and Derek Faya. Faya looking back door and reading that pass all the way was Jackson Thomas, and he will send it all the way down. Half a minute remaining on the Swampscott power play. Turnover here, Bikini got the steal. DJ Bikini in the near corner. As Beverly has done a good job on the forecheck here during this penalty kill. And it's prevented Big Blue from really establishing some comfort on this power play. And the power play comes to an end. We are back to even strength. And moving in was Will Roddy for Big Blue, and he'll be able to track the puck down. Roddy looking into the slot for Langevin, and he'll have it taken away. Matthew Mezzo on the move up the near side. Mezzo only has one defender to beat, and he's kept outside. Meza getting help from Cook down below the goal, and a whistle coming. Let's see who the penalty is on this time. Gonna be a hooking call. And it looks like this hooking call will be against Big Blue, as heading to the box for Swampscott to serve as their first penalty of the night is Ben Tolosa, and the sophomore will take a seat in the sin bin. Beverly with their first man advantage of the evening. Meza out there with Jackson Thomas as well as Cam Cook, among others. Cook, the shot from the far point, a stop quickly by Buford. Gavin Lawrence also out there with Meza and Cook. And then Jackson Thomas in there as well with Austin Bernard to complete the five men on this power play for the Panthers. Thomas below goal, going up top. A chance for Lawrence and a pad stop by Buford. Puck went out of play, so it will keep this next faceoff in the Beverly offensive end. Still a minute and 46 seconds to go on this Panther power play. To the far side, Cook going cross ice. Bernard, he scores! Austin Bernard! The second Beverly goal here in the first, and a 2-0 Panther advantage here on senior night. So Beverly, after killing off a penalty earlier in this first period, take advantage of a power play of their own, and they have added a second goal to complement Jackson Thomas's opening tally, and Austin Bernard to do the deed. For Bernard, according to MassHighSchoolHockey.com, that is his fourth goal of the season. So the Beverly power play has concluded with that goal by Bernard, and we are back to even strength, a 2-0 Panther advantage, and it is still only the first period. Now below the goal, Panthers trying to move it back out in front, but it's quickly taken away and cleared by Papalardo.
Beverly goal, scoring number 11, Austin Bernard.
Now on the near side, Timothy Sullivan trying to force it up the near board. He'll get some help from Cappuccetti to move it out to center. Chance brewing here for Big Blue. Balchenkov working behind the goal. Has it taken off of his stick on another strong defensive play on the back end for the Panthers by Timothy Sullivan. And now DJ Bikini moving the other way as the puck moved off of his stick by Quinn Hitchcock. Bikini trying to get it back, and it looks like he hit the post. So DJ Bikini could have been the third senior to add a goal to the score sheet already in this game. But Jason Buford's best friend, the post, helping him out there. And Swampscott will dump it down and get fresh legs on the ice with under five remaining in the first. Jackson Thomas up the far boards, he'll connect. And Beverly on the move in the offensive direction. Pass back up top, forced to be moved back out to center. Robert Massa had to backtrack for it as it's pushed down into Big Blue's end once more. Matthew Meza the steal, low circle, looking back into the slot, as right there ready was Aiden LeBlanc, but it went right under LeBlanc's stick. Beverly moving it back in to Swampscott's end again. Another shot from Massa and a stop by Buford. Under four to go in the first. Two goals already on the board for the Panthers on senior night, and both of them coming from seniors. Can't get much more poetic than that, as tying it up on the side of the goal is Buford for a stoppage. 3:41 to go in the first.
Oh,
Meza remaining out there in the faceoff circle against Aiden Sprague. Meza won it initially, but picking up the loose puck was TJ McCarthy. Now below the goal, Sprague. Beverly to keep it in. As they cycle between the wings and the D, put on goal, another stop for Buford. And finally Sprague moving the other way, feeding it near side for his left winger, Zach Pierce. Pierce trying to dance by the outstretched stick of Timothy Sullivan, but the Panthers will clear it out quickly. Austin Bernard, the most recent goal scorer, off a ricochet from Meza. Bernard to pick it up high, slot! And he puts it over the net on the glove side. Pierce able to move it into the Beverly zone, and Sprague with the reinforcement as that first unit takes a seat for Big Blue. Nice steal in mid-ice here. Jackson Bartram will push it behind Beverly's goal. Cappuccetti up the near board as it moved out to center. Rocco Orlandella was the one to push it out for the Panthers. And now Beverly in their offensive end near side. High slot Orlandella, his shot got blocked. Beverly will try again. A second shot from the point is blocked. This time Robert Massa took it. And I think that was two blocks in a row for Jackson Bartram. So a strong defensive contribution for Big Blue so far by Bartram. And the other way, quickly, Balchenkov trying to push it back toward the slot as Bartram was crashing, but Beverly will move it out to neutral ice. Back and forth we go in the later part of this first period as a little bit more parity being established here after an early advantage gained by the Panthers with two quick goals on the board. Bikini looking back out in front. Nobody was home. The only one that was in the general area for Beverly was Jeffrey Hallinan. Hallinan to keep it in. Bikini feeding it cross ice. Jackson Thomas, he fires and a stop by Buford. Got it with the shoulder there. Now backtracking is Gavin Lawrence into his own end. He'll slam on the brakes behind his goaltender and start this movement forward. He's heavily pressured by two Big Blue players, but finally gets it away, and Jackson Thomas will push it back in Big Blue's direction. No icing the call, as it looked like it got touched by Hallinan before it made its way all the way down. Beverly's forecheck continuing to pay dividends and really stifle the advances of Swampscott so far in this first, as we're under a minute to go in the first period. Starting the rush is Will Roddy. Roddy across the line, I slot, and a stop by O'Connell. So James O'Connell hasn't been super busy here in the first period, but up to the task on every shot he's faced thus far. Still 33 seconds left in period one. Face off to the right of O'Connell is won by the Panthers, and they're on the move quickly. Matthew Meza across the line near side. Meza trying to dance toward the low circle, had it pushed off his stick at the very last second by Ben Tolosa. And now Swampscott looking to respond, only 15 seconds left. Gadon tried to put it toward goal. Cappuccetti with the block. Gadon looking back out in front. Sprague couldn't quite get his stick on it, so he'll go over and dig it out on the far board. 3 seconds left. Beverly to pin it below goal with Meza as the clock strikes zero to conclude this first period of play. And what a big, booming first 15 minutes it was here at the Raymond J. Bourque Arena. And after one, the Beverly Panthers here on senior night lead 2-0. Goals coming from Jackson Thomas early in the first, and then Austin Bernard adding a goal of his own to account for the score we see as we look towards the first intermission here in Beverly. A 2-0 Beverly lead. We'll be back in a flash. I'm JJ Sylvia.
Here, anyone can come to the studio to make their own local TV show. Contact us with your idea. We'll help you get started with producing your own show, editing it, and then we'll broadcast it to all of Beverly for your friends and family to see. You might even get some new fans. We also film local events like sports, music, city council meetings, and more. If you miss out on anything in town, you can catch up on it here. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Contact us at 978-927-5544 or email us at admin@bevcam.org.
Got a quarter?
Most party fouls are pretty dumb. But if you decide to drink and drive underage, you could lose your license and your freedom. Underage drinking and driving. The ultimate party foul.
Everything starts out small. The things that hurt us, they all start from somewhere. The words we say, the things we do, that can grow into something else. What was small and innocent can become big and sometimes scary. All it takes is one comment, one picture, one video for something to catch fire. But a big problem doesn't need a big response. Not at first. Even if we don't know what to say, the eye emoji can be that first step we take. Let's all pledge to take that first small step together and change the world in a big way. I'm a witness, and so are you.
Everybody has a dream. Mine was to see the ocean. And with a little help, I made it.
They told me a bottle couldn't dream. That I would never become a superhero. But I learned how to fly. Just to come back in a new disguise. And be the hero that I've always wanted to be.
Listen.
All it took was someone who would insist that I just try.
Suddenly, everything was turned around because they judge you.
You tell them, I don't need this.
No one is going to understand.
Unless they've been through it, how can they?
Then one day you realize...
You feel so hopeless.
I need help. I need help.
You feel so hopeless.
Then one day you realize...
Unless they've been through it, how can they understand?
I don't need this.
No one's going to judge you.
Suddenly everything was turned around because they insist that I just try.
All it took was someone who would just...
Listen.
We'll be right back.
here at the Raymond J. Bork Arena. J.J. Silvio along with you here on BevCam Sportsnet as we start the second period of play. And in the first, Beverly jumping out to a 2-0 advantage. Jackson Thomas and Austin Bernard with the goals. Both seniors making big contributions on their senior day. So more than one reason to celebrate for Jackson Thomas and Austin Bernard on this evening as Swampscott will get a goal on the board here as a bit of an unexpected one, but a tip in front does the job and scoring for Big Blue is Max Gadon, the first line right winger. And Beverly's 2-0 lead has been cut in half. So Max Gadon getting on the board for Big Blue. For Gadon, according to MassHighSchoolHockey.com, that was his sixth goal of the season. And Beverly will now look to respond as they got two goals quickly on the board in the first, and now Swampscott flipping the script on the hometown Panthers, getting a goal of their own early in the second. Swampscott trying for two, and just keeping it out there was O'Connell. Now a pass up top for a shot, once again stopped by O'Connell. TJ McCarthy took that one, and now the Panthers leading up ahead here, and a chance moving into the zone, and offside is called as Aiden LeBlanc was a bit ahead of the play and crossed the blue line before the puck did. And that will bring the faceoff just outside of the Panthers' offensive zone in front of their bench. And for the Panthers, interim head coach Jim Sasso has to be quite exuberant with his team's first period performance. No goals registered on the board in that first, and two goals registered for the Panthers. Beverly able to gain the zone. Last to touch the puck was Bradley McAlpine. McAlpine waiting in the slot. Almost got a pass right to him from Cameron Cook. But it's moved back out to center. Back in the other direction comes Big Blue. Far side, it's Hurley. Hurley has it pushed off his stick by Cappuccetti, and it'll be moved out by the Panthers. McAlpine fighting for it on that far board, and Beverly will force it down on to Buford and Big Blue to regroup from their own end. Pass a little bit too hard there from his own zone by Zach Ryan, and it will bring on an icing and a faceoff to come back down into Big Blue's end. 12:47 to go here in the middle frame. Faceoff lost there by Cameron Cook, as it looks like Jim Sasso will try and alternate the center position on that top unit. We saw Matthew Meza primarily as the center in the first period, but now Cam Cook replacing Meza on that last faceoff. So some potential competition for that top line center position. It really could come down to who's winning the draws on a given night. Meza near board will push it down below goal. Cook to give chase, trying to take it from Hitchcock. Kept in up top, a shot and another save for Buford. Puck still loose, Austin Bernard to grab it. Bernard pushing it up top. Sullivan, his shot, looks like it hit the crossbar. So another close call for Jason Buford. He's been helped out twice by either the post or the crossbar so far in this one. It could be potentially a 4-1 game had it not been for the goalie's best friend. Cook up the far board, connects with Meza. Meza has Bernard for help as he gains the line. Meza far side, tried to pick the top corner, but missed on the blocker side. Big Blue quickly back in the other direction. Roddy was across the red line before he got pushed off the puck. And now DJ Bikini to dump it down and in on the near side. Roddy near board, looking up ahead for Langevin. And Javen had it for a moment, but had it pushed off his stick by Jackson Thomas. Back in the other direction come the Panthers. Hallinan, far side, had a shot blocked on its way in. Quinn Hitchcock got in there on the block. Puck pushed over the goal, and it looks like it got stuck on top of James O'Connell's net. So a faceoff will come in Beverly's defensive end. That stops the clock with 10:58 to go in the second. So glad you could all join us here for Senior Night here on BevCam Sportsnet as the Beverly Panthers take on the Swampscott Big Blue in a Northeastern Conference matchup. Bikini long shot sticked away by Buford. Up the far board, Bauchenkov has it pushed off his stick. Chance brewing for the Panthers, and unable to get a pass to connect in that slot for Beverly was Aiden LeBlanc. And an offside call coming here as Cappuccetti was unable to keep it in the zone. So what started as a heavily Beverly favored game has quickly turned on its heels following a goal for Swampscott. And Max Gadon's tally could have been what really shifts the momentum. And another goal, and we could see a brand new hockey game. Aiden Sprague near side. Beverly able to push it off his stick. Back the other way come the Panthers. Pass toward the back door as we've seen some good rushes so far today by Rocco Orlandella, as well as numerous others, including Bradley McAlpine, for this Beverly squad. They've really been looking to make those smart passes in the offensive end, and those will pay dividends, even if they don't initially get the results that a team wants. Those right decisions, when made 2, 3, 4 times in a row, can really mean for a greater shift in momentum in either team's direction. And it looks like Swampscott is set to head back to the power play. And let's see who heads to the box for Beverly. And for the Panthers, serving this penalty will be Jack Cameron. Cameron, one of the seniors, being honored in the pregame ceremonies, and he will take a seat in the sin bin. And the Panthers now have to kill off a second Swampscott power play. Big Blues 0-for-1 tonight on the man advantage. Now Cook with a shorthanded breakaway chance moving in. He scores! Cam Cook does the gritty right after. And it's a 3-1 Beverly lead. So Cam Cook, the third senior to register a goal tonight for the Gulls. And according to MassHighSchoolHockey.com, for Cam Cook, that will be the third goal of the year for the senior, according to MassHighSchoolHockey.com. And now three different seniors starting off this senior night on the right foot for the Panthers, and they're up 3-1 with under 10 minutes to go in the second. Beverly able to move it out. So the Panthers not only doing a stellar job of killing penalties so far, they've even been able to muster a shorthanded goal. And a one-goal lead has now been expanded back to two for Beverly. Still a minute left on this Big Blue power play, and Austin Bernard to tip that pass back out to center, as Beverly's done a great job, especially with their wingers, of clogging those D-to-D passing lanes. DJ Bikini stealing mid-ice. Bikini on the move, had one defender to beat, but he had the puck pushed off his stick by Aiden Sprague. Puck moved back in to the Swampscott end. Big Blue trying to regroup. Austin Bernard, a second straight interception, but he couldn't keep it on his stick this time. Quinn Hitchcock on the move for Big Blue. His shot and a stop by O'Connell. having to backtrack out at center is Max Gadon. He'll look back up ahead on the near board as it's pushed down below the Beverly goal. Cappuccetti has it stolen from him. Zach Pierce working near board, going up top. Now to the far side. Shot tipped in front. Not sure if O'Connell even saw it. TJ McCarthy among those. And Aiden Fitzpatrick, the one who took the shot. Now another breakaway brewing. Austin Bernard looking for goal number two. And he seals it. Top shelf, Austin Bernard. And the goals just keep coming for the home squad. It is 4-1 here in the second. Second goal of the game for Austin Bernard. Beverly now with their largest lead of the game. And what was once bad has gotten worse for the visiting squad, the Big Blue. Now a 3-goal deficit for Swampscott to build their way out of. Timothy Sullivan trying to work it out of his own end. He'll get some help from Orlandella. But back on Sullivan's stick again. He'll go cross ice, and his pass will connect with McAlpine before Swampscott looks to regroup with possession. Balchenkov finding his man in Aiden Fitzpatrick, and he'll go up the near board before Beverly ping-pongs it back onto Buford, who has to make a reflex save. Cappuccetti, mid-ice, pushes it up ahead, and he'll find McAlpine for the dump-in. Another chance from a bad angle, and just barely missing the net there was Rocco Orlandella, and he could have been the fourth senior to net a goal tonight for the Panthers. Orlandella still working, getting some help as it's pushed toward goal, and Buford the stop. That time McAlpine got a shot on goal, and now there's a scuffle for the puck. Four players down below the goal trying to grab it. Orlandella coming away with it, feeding it back below the goal once more. Orlandella was able to find his teammate in Jack Cameron before Swampscott got it off his stick and moved it out to center. Austin Bernard back again for the Panthers. Who knows, by the end of tonight, Bernard could be looking at a hat trick. He's only one goal shy and still has about a period and a quarter left to be played. Matthew Meza, one of the Beverly captains, working far corner. Wraps it around to the near side. Cook trying to get it away from Bartram, and Bartram will win that battle and force it down into Beverly's end for the Panthers to try once more. 5:20 to go in the second period, and Beverly, after seeing Swampscott dwindle their lead to just one, has added two unanswered. And now Meza firing, and it trickles between Buford's legs, and a goal! Matthew Meza with even more magic here on senior night. A 5-1 Beverly lead. It's an onslaught at this point. The fourth different Panther to net a goal, and it's still only the second period. 5 minutes still to go, folks. What an electric home game here on senior night. We could not have asked for anything better. DJ McKinney! Beverly just will not stop and add McKinney's name to the list of seniors to net a goal tonight. And McKinney with a gritty of his own. It's 6-1 Panthers. Will be the night for Jason Buford, as head coach Gino Faya has seen enough and he pulls him from the game. And that will give eighth grader Dom Papalardo a chance in between the pipes. Really a worst case scenario here for Swampscott. I can't imagine Big Blue will go away easily, however. I would not be surprised if, when we see the final score after the third, this game looks a lot closer than it does right now. Jackson Thomas to keep it in near side. He'll shove it back below the Swamp Scott goal. A 5-goal advantage here for the Panthers as the floodgates have really been blown open here in the second period. Now Zach Ryan forcing it up the near board. Max Gadon had it pushed off his stick, and Beverly will thump it back in to Swamp Scott's end again. Thomas able to keep it in once more as he has been a brick wall at the blue line in this game so far. Big steal here in the slot. And once again, the Panthers knocking on the door. That was Dylan Alves this time. Alves trying to help out another one of his teammates as Chase O'Brien had a chance to walk down Broadway, but Swamp Scott will clear. Far board, Orlandella finds Jackson Thomas, and now Thomas shoveling it forward for McAlpine. McAlpine far board with 3.5 to go, has it dressed off his stick and pushed out of the zone by Quinn Hitchcock. A 6-1 Beverly advantage and 5 different goal scorers for the Panthers in this one. Austin Bernard with 2. And a truly comfortable cushion for the hometown Panthers to play with as this second period dwindles down to an end. Swamp Scott trying to maintain offensive zone presence. A chance in the high slot. Pushed towards goal and O'Connell the stop. But he had some trouble corralling the rebound. Now far board. Puck battled for and pushed forward by Langevin below the goal. Now far side. It's worked back out to neutral ice. Austin Bernard trying to track it down just in front of our broadcast booth. Has it taken away before he could get there. And Quinn Hitchcock will dump it down. Matthew Meza grabbing the loose puck in mid-ice, and the Panthers have numbers moving this way. Meza dumping it off for Cook. Cook back into the slot. Meza was there, couldn't get a stick on it. A shot from the point and a blocker save. First big stop there for Dom Pappalardo. Beverly regrouping once more, passing to neutral ice. Bernard couldn't handle it, and pushing it back the other way is Ben Tolosa. Under 2 minutes to go in this middle frame. And Beverly has piled the goals on here in the second. They started off up 2-0 at the beginning of this period, and it seemed like Swamp Scott might be able to even up this game at the start of this period when they got the first tally on the board, courtesy of Max Gadon. But since then, it has been all Beverly as another stop fairly easily this time for James O'Connell. And a faceoff coming to his left with a minute and 26 seconds left in the period. So I spoke about the large fan section that came out to support this squad tonight on senior night. And man, oh man, are the Panther faithful getting an absolute treat tonight from their boys hockey program. A 6-1, 5-goal advantage. Scare there for O'Connell. Swamp Scott has had chances, but really hasn't cashed in. Beverly on the move, into the slot. Bikini just couldn't handle the pass. Pass came from Hallinan, and it was a well-set-up pass as well. All Bikini had to do was really tip it on goal, and he just could not corral it. Under a minute to go in the period. Swamp Scott will clear it as it will trickle all the way to O'Connell, and now Jackson. And no icing the call, as Hallinan may have gotten a piece of it. Bikini in there on the forecheck will find the puck in the near corner. DJ Bikini going up top. Jackson Thomas, his slap shot, and a big save there for the eighth grader in Dom Pappalardo. That stops the clock with 23 seconds still remaining in a eventful second period. Panthers win another draw, chance, and finishing it off at the back door for Beverly is Dylan Alves. Alves, the sixth senior to score for the Panthers tonight. And with 18 seconds to go in this period, it is 7-1, Beverly. And talk about a momentum swing, and a radical one at that. It looked like Swampscott had all of that blown it open. As the clock will strike zero with the Panthers gaining the blue line to conclude this second period of play. And my, oh my, where do I even start, folks? We started off the game with Jackson Thomas and Austin Bernard netting the first two in period one. But then in the second, Austin Bernard, DJ Bikini, Dylan Alves, Cam Cook, Matthew Meza, all scoring for the Panthers. And we see a 7-1 score right now as we look towards the third and final frame. We will take one more short break, and we will be back on the other side here on BevCam Sportsnet.
You are watching BevCam. Here, anyone can come to the studio to make their own local TV show. Contact us with your idea. We'll help you get started with producing your own show, editing it, then we'll broadcast it to all of Beverly for your friends and family to see. You might even get some new fans. We also film local events like sports, music, city council meetings, and more. If you miss out on anything in town, you can catch up on it here. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Contact us at 978-927-5544 or email us at admin@bevcam.org.
Got a quarter?
Most party fouls are pretty dumb. But if you decide to drink and drive underage, you could lose your license and your freedom. Underage drinking and driving, the ultimate party foul.
Everything starts out small. The things that hurt us, they all start from somewhere. The words we say, the things we do, that can grow into something else. What was small and innocent can become big and sometimes scary. All it takes is one comment, one picture, one video for something to catch fire. But a big problem doesn't need a big response. Not at first. Even if we don't know what to say, the eye emoji can be that first step we take. Let's all pledge to take that first small step together and change the world in a big way. I'm a witness, and so are you.
Everybody has a dream.
They told me a bottle couldn't dream. That I would never become a superhero. But I learned how to fly. Just to come back in a new disguise. And be the hero that I've always wanted to be.
Listen.
All it took was someone who would insist that I just try.
Suddenly, everything was turned around because they judge you.
You tell them, I don't need this.
No one is going to understand.
Unless they've been through it, how can they?
Then one day you realize...
You feel so hopeless.
I need help. I need help.
You feel so hopeless.
Then one day you realize...
Unless they've been through it, how can they understand?
I don't need this.
No one's going to judge you.
Suddenly everything was turned around because they insist that I just try.
All it took was someone who would just...
Listen.
I'm on fire.
to win a medal in the 50-50 raffle momentarily. Get the ticket ready.
Welcome back into the Raymond J. Bork Arena, everyone. JJ Sylvia back with you here on BevCam Sportsnet. And if you're just tuning in with us, folks, you have missed a lot. A 7-1 Beverly lead. And after the first period, you would not have thought that this game would be where it is now. It was only 2-1 after one period. Or sorry, 2-0 after one period. Austin Bernard and Jackson Thomas with the goals. And then at the beginning of the second, it was cut to a 2-1 lead for the Panthers off of a tally from Swampscott's first line left winger, Max Gaudon. And then the Panthers with five different goal scorers in the second period expanded their lead exponentially, I think would be the word to use. And it is a 7-1, six goal advantage for this home squad in white on their senior night as we're underway here in the third and final period. Jackson Thomas to keep it in far side. He winds up and a quick stop by Pat Bilardo. Beverly to keep possession. Austin Bernard on the near board. Couldn't quite corral it. And Max Gaudon will work it back out to neutral ice. Gaudon feeding Zach Pierce for the dump in. Bernard to gather it, feeding Meza up ahead across the line. Meza pushing it into the slot at it, brushed off his stick at the last second by Derek Faya. But Meza will get it back and muscle it forward. Swampscott able to keep Beverly's offense at bay here in the first couple of minutes of this third period. It's a similar story to what we saw at the beginning of period two. Swampscott coming out with a bit of a pep in their step, kind of catching the Panthers off guard. But then, as we saw in the second period, Beverly really just took control of this game. And they have not let go. They've kept their foot on the gas pedal, 110% effort, and it has resulted in a much pleasing score for the Panthers. Swampscott still with a period to work with. They could most certainly add some positivity to what has been a rough evening if they can get some goals on the board, or we can see some key saves made by the backup goaltender in Pappalardo. But right now, among the positive talking points for Swampscott, Jason Buford, despite getting the yank from head coach Gino Fea, definitely made some clutch saves, especially with the glove, while he was in between the pipes, and now he's relieved. Bikini on the move here for the Panthers, near side. DJ has to hesitate a little bit as he was heavily guarded by Hurley. And back the other way comes Big Blue. Jackson Thomas, just recently being relieved, is stepping on the ice for him as well. Ten Hope, and Ten Hope feeding up ahead. Bikini, near side, hit the bar. So that's three hit posts today for the Panthers. Now Will Ten Hope fires on a left pad save by Pappalardo. Beverly trying to keep it in, and they will for the moment, as it's worked out to neutral ice. Fourth we go here in the third period. Neither team really establishing their dominance yet in this new frame, as it's worked up the far board, stealing mid-ice here for Orlandella, but he has it quickly pushed off his stick by his number partner in Aiden Sprague. Sprague getting help from Quinn Hitchcock. Hitchcock moving through the neutral zone into the offensive zone. A shot, and I don't know if O'Connell got a piece of it, but nonetheless, it goes over the goal. Now behind the Beverly goal, Gavin Lawrence going up the far board. It's kept in by Hitchcock. A chance in front, and keeping it out is O'Connell. The Beverly defense also stepping up, as it looked like Gavin Lawrence had a blocked shot. Pass up top for a clapper from the point by McCarthy. Never made its way through to James O'Connell, and Beverly will finally move it out of the zone. pushed below the Swampscott goal. Big Blue trying to clear quickly. That will not happen. Alves to keep it in up top. Thomas! Looks like it didn't get all the way through. Now Thomas, far point. He fires another shot, sailing up and over the goal. And a whistle as it looks like it went out of play. And that'll stop the clock. 10:43 to go in this third period. So lots of big, booming offensive plays in the first two periods. And in this third so far, the tempo has really settled down quite a bit. And now these two squads engaged in a battle of inches in a decisive third period. But nonetheless, I have to keep mentioning Swampscott. They have a lot of strong players on the squad. You give them some momentum with a goal or two, and this game could be flipped on its head in an instant. Still plenty of time left, 10.5 minutes remaining. Now on the far corner, Quinn Hitchcock feeding it back into neutral ice. Puck ricocheted off the stick of Langevin. Langevin will give chase down below the Beverly goal as it's worked over to the far board. Dylan Alves tries to work it back out to center before it's ping-ponged back in by Cody Langevin. And once again, Beverly to reset. Panthers passing in this period has been a little less fluid than it was in the first two. Hitchcock the other way, moving in near side as it dressed off his stick at nearly the last second by Robert Massa. But that's a good job by Massa of keeping him to the outside and not letting him get a clear shot on goal. Single digits of minutes remaining in this one, 9:38 to go. And a commanding lead for the Beverly Panthers, 7-1. And six different goal scorers tonight for Beverly. And at this point, if the Panthers are looking for anything, perhaps they'll try to get Austin Bernard goal number 3 on the day to give him a senior night hat trick. And what a momentous way to celebrate your hockey career. No better way than with a hat trick on senior day. Meza had it pushed off his stick. Cook to help him. Cook, low circle. Bernard back in front, and Meza will tuck in the rebound for the 8th Beverly goal. Matthew Meza with his 2nd goal of the game, and he hits another gritty. And the Panthers are relentless. An 8-1 Beverly lead now. So two of Beverly's captains registering a pair of goals tonight. Austin Bernard and Matthew Meza, both with 2 apiece. Now Bikini, high slot, tried to dangle by a defender, but Liam Hurley standing his ground to push the puck off of number 8 stick. Bikini to get it back below the goal will push it down further. Hallinan trying to feed it into the slot, and Swampscott finally able to move it out. At number 9! And another senior adding his name to the score sheet, and it's Will Tenhope! And the Panthers 1 goal shy of double digits on the night, and a gritty himself for Will Tenhope. It is all smiles tonight for Beverly. Seven different goal scorers tonight for the Panthers. A true team effort, and with 8:32 to go, a 9-1 Beverly lead. Still the only goal on the night for Swampscott coming from Max Gaudin at the beginning of the second, but other than that, Swampscott has been kept silent offensively. Delayed offsides will allow Beverly more time on the breakout. Trying to feed it up the far board was Robert Massa. It was kept in momentarily by Zach Pierce. And now Sprague trying to dress it away from a Beverly player in neutral ice. He'll do so and feed it up ahead. Zach Pierce, high circle, Pierce into the slot. Fires on another stop by O'Connell. Puck loose in front. O'Connell has it under him. And he will pin it there for a stop. And my oh my, other than the one goal tonight for Big Blue, you have to do nothing but praise junior goaltender James O'Connell. He has been calm, cool, and collected in between the pipes. And he's one of the main reasons why this game has been so pro-Beverly. Panthers able to move it out as Ethan Height will push it down the near board and into Swampscott's end. Height wearing number 3, by far the shortest player on the ice. Another chance for the Panthers, and just barely missing the 10th goal is Timothy Carter. Cappuccetti pushing it below goal, getting help from Height. And now Swampscott will look to clear. And they do, as a dump down and in by Zach Pierce will initiate a change for Big Blue. Cappuccetti tried to feed it forward, went off the skate of Langevin before it's finally worked out to neutral ice, and Height with the puck on the near board. Height able to advance it into the zone, and now he'll have some help. Puck loose in the low slot, and finally Hitchcock able to pick it up, and he'll move up this near board. When Hitchcock across the blue line, looking for a retreating pass. Puck still loose, picked up by Langevin for a shot, and it's smothered by James O'Connell. 6:39 remaining here at the Bork. Beverly one goal shy of 10 on the night. And now you've got two potential players who, with one more goal, could notch a hat trick on senior night. Austin Bernard and Matthew Meza, both with two goals apiece. Below the Beverly goal, Lawrence going up the far board. Beverly having a bit of trouble breaking it out, and they finally do get it out to center. Orlandella engaged in a battle with Rothwell. And now Swampscott will look to respond to what has been a pretty much all Beverly second half of this game. As we go under, 6 minutes remaining. Jack Cameron, far board, gets absolutely flattened by Derek Fire. Swampscott moving it out. Will Roddy across the line, tried to get a shot off, but he had it pushed off his stick by Robert Massa. Now below the goal, Will Ten Hope with two Big Blue right on him, has it taken off his stick. Now below the goal. Puck grabbed and moved out of the Beverly zone all by himself in that process is Timothy Carter. Puck moved into the Swampscott end now. 5:15 to go. Beverly pressuring for yet another goal. They could hit double digits with the next tally. Jackson Thomas pushes it over to the near corner. Puck pushed back below the goal once more. Beverly killing clock as well as looking for another tally at this point. Thomas on the far side and a pad save by Papalardo. I'll tell you what, Dom Papalardo, only an eighth grader, he has been stellar since relieving Jason Buford. Has had a couple of pounces not go his way, but other than that, he has really been exceptional, especially for an eighth grader playing at the varsity level. It's an intimidating task to begin with, just based on Papalardo's age, but between the pipes for Swampscott. Now Will Ten Hope trying to move it out of his own zone, has it taken away. Pierce looking into the slot, but a great job defensively of not overcommitting to either player and just clogging the passing lane. Cappuccetti, the senior, was the one who did it. And that senior experience showing there for Matthew Cappuccetti. A scuffle here in front of the Beverly bench for the puck as it's finally moved into neutral ice. Under 4 minutes to go in this one. Beverly has been in the driver's seat since the middle of the second period. And they have not taken their foot off the gas pedal since. Will Ten Hope to push it in to the Swampscott end. Ben Tolosa to gather it there. Now near board, Sprague gains the red line, dumps it in. Gino Fea keeping the shift short for his big blue here at the end. Shot from the point and just going over the net there was TJ McCarthy. McCarthy visibly frustrated after that shot as not many bounces have gone big blue's way tonight. Quickly the other way come the Panthers. Gavin Lawrence unable to convert. Beverly still pressuring before Steele in the slot turns a Will Roddy up ahead. Roddy puts it on goal and O'Connell with an easy save covering it up with traffic on the way. 2:49 remaining. So the Beverly Panthers, on a day of much celebration, have even more to celebrate, as this game has been a true testament to all the hard work the Panthers have put in on the ice this season. Cook almost had a block and breakaway opportunity there. Now a long pass up ahead. Cook with a breakaway chance if he can track it down, but pouncing on the puck to prevent anything from happening is the eighth grader, Dom Pappalardo. 2:34 left on the clock in this one. Austin Bernard back out there. He's one of those Panthers who's one goal shy of a Hattie. So let's see if they can get it for Bernard on this shift. Cook also out there and Jackson Thomas as well as the seniors represented in this group of five for the Panthers. Bernard, high slot, had it blocked in front. Looks like Hitchcock got in there and now he'll turn D into O. Quinn Hitchcock across the line fires and O'Connell will make the save and pounce on the loose puck to prevent any rebounds. Lots of play stoppages here at the end of this game as Swampscott is trying everything that they have to notch another tally before the end of regulation. Face off won by the Panthers to the far side. Hallinan getting help from Will Ten Hope, who wraps it back near towards connecting with DJ Bikini. Panthers have numbers 3-on-2 the other way. Bikini near side had it pushed off his stick. Strong defensive play on the back end for Jason Rothwell. Rothwell, another one of those eighth graders on this Swampscott squad, a very young group with the exception of a few juniors that they have on this squad. And a few seniors as well, Max Gadon being one of them. Under a minute and a half to go, Steele in mid-ice. Max Gadon had it pushed off his stick before he could really get a shot off. That's Will Ten Hope stepping up defensively once again. Another steal here for the Panthers. Orlandella across the line near side. Orlandella gets knocked down below the goal. Beverly still pressuring. Rothwell wraps around his team's goal, goes up the near board. Looks like the Panthers keep it in with under a minute to go. Rothwell finally able to clear it out. And Gadon will dump it down towards O'Connell as it sputters over to the near board. Zach Pierce going up top, a shot from the point, O'Connell the stop, and it trickles below goal as Cappuccetti tried to move out. He got knocked down by Max Gadon. Now the near side, Fitzpatrick to keep it in. Fitzpatrick, high circle, fires. It's loose in front, and a whistle. As a penalty comes up here, a cross-check called. Let's see who it's on, and it will be on Aiden Sprague. So another Swampscott penalty, and Beverly for the last 22 seconds of this game will be on the man advantage. But I'm not assuming that they have much urgency to add another goal, already up 9-1. Face-off coming to the left of Dom Pappalardo. Puck being battled for below Pappalardo's goal, pushed up the far board. Will Ten Hope twice able to keep it in at the line, but he gets flattened by Max Gaudin. And Gaudin will get the puck in mid-ice and dump it down into the Beverly end. Jackson Thomas there as the clock will strike zero. And this game ends in momentous fashion for the Beverly Panthers. A 9-1 victory here at home tonight on senior night, and the Panthers grab a huge conference win here against the Swampscott Big Blue. Final score here tonight, 9-1 in favor of the Beverly Panthers. Goals for Beverly scored by Austin Bernard with 2, Matthew Mezzo with 2, Cam Cook, DJ Bikini, Dylan Alves, Will Tenhope, and Jackson Thomas to account for all 9 Beverly tallies, and then the lone goal for the Swampscott Big Blue coming off the stick of forward Max Gaudin, and that accounts for the final score of 9-1, and that will do it for us tonight here on BevCam Sportsnet. For our entire crew, I'm JJ Sylvia, wishing you a good rest of your Saturday night.